picking up good vibrations. She's giving me the excitations. I'm picking up good vibrations. She's giving me the excitations. Hey, it's Eric with the Crested Butte Avalanche Center. Today's Wednesday, January 19th. And today, myself and Zach Kindler came out to East Beckwith. We haven't been out to this area yet since the holiday stormy period. We were aware of some of the big avalanches out here, but we wanted to come take a look first at hand at the destruction. And so the avalanche path behind me started in that big bowl. It's half sun, half shade, and it extended its trim line on both sides and at the terminus, knocking over a lot of trees. But in the last 19 or so days since this avalanche ran, a lot has changed with the snowpack. So let's head on up onto the slopes of East Beckwith and show you what the snowpack looks like and why avalanches like this are extremely unlikely now. Slabs are thick and weak layers have improved. So let's go take a look. So I'm at 10,500 feet northeast facing slope on East Beckwith Mountain. And this is why we're at low danger. We have this huge, hard slab all the way down to here that formed in December, capping our weak layers at the ground down here. The weak layers at this site are showing a lot of increased hardness. They're rounding and sintering and becoming much stronger, and are not all that worrisome anymore. There are some places where you can still potentially trigger avalanches.
Extreme terrain on the north half of the compass, where you find shallow, rocky, wind-affected snow, are places where there's still potential for you to trigger an avalanche. These images give some examples of that type of terrain. Stay up to date on conditions by heading to cbavalanchecenter.org to read the full forecast.
Yeah, good stability here. Really good stability.
Definitely no propagation there.